हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इंसिडेंट्स ऑफ टैक्स लायबिलिटी और स्कोप ऑफ टोटल इनकम. इंसिडेंट्स ऑफ टैक्स लायबिलिटी मीन्स द फाइनल बर्डन ऑफ टैक्स हु हैज टू पे द इनकम टैक्स टू द गवर्नमेंट. सो हियर एन इंडिविजुअल इज लायबल टू पे टैक्स टू द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द टू कंडीशन, दैट इज हिज रेसिडेंशियल स्टेटस इन इंडिया एंड बेस्ड ऑन द प्लेस एंड टाइम ऑफ accrual or receipt of income. Means here an individual, he is liable to pay income tax to the Indian government in the he has to pay income tax in the assessment year based on the income earned in the previous year. So here an individual has to pay income tax on the Indian income, on the income earned in India, and as well as on income earned outside India. So there is a condition based on his residential status in India, whether he is a ordinarily resident, whether he is a not ordinarily resident and non-resident. Based on the residential status in India in the previous year, and as well as based on the place and time of accrual, means whether that income is earned in India or whether it is earned in the outside India, whether that income is earned, time means whether that income is earned in the concerned previous year or it is earned in the other previous year. So that is based on the place and time of accrual or receipt of income as well as the residential status in India. Based on these two conditions, an individual is liable to pay tax to the Indian government. So now we'll see what is the condition in case of ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident and non-resident. So in case of ordinarily resident, the condition is an ordinarily resident in India. So the person who becomes ordinarily resident in India during the previous year is taxable in respect of both the Indian income and foreign income. If the income is earned in India and as well as if the income is earned outside India, both the income, on both the income he has to pay the income tax. An ordinarily resident, he has to pay tax on both the income, Indian income as well as foreign income. Next, in case of not ordinarily resident, here a not ordinarily resident is taxable in respect of Indian income and income earned from a business, foreign business controlled from India. Means here not ordinarily resident, he has to pay income tax on the Indian income. If the income is earned in India, then he has to pay income tax, as well as if the income is earned from a foreign business, the business is foreign business and which is controlled from India, means the business is controlled in India, the business is set up in India, so the any branch or headquarter is set up in India, then for that income also he has to pay income tax. Not ordinarily resident has to pay income tax on the Indian income as well as the income, if that income earned from a foreign business, it is a foreign business income but controlled from India, then he has to pay income tax. In case of non-resident, a non-resident is taxable only in respect of Indian income. If income is earned in India, then non-resident has to pay a income tax. So now we'll see what is the income, Indian income and foreign income. Indian income means if income received or earned accrued in India, income received or earned accrued in India in the previous year. So if income, whatever the income received by an individual, or if the income is earned but not received also, he has to it is treated as an Indian income. If income is deemed to be received or deemed to be earned in India, then it is treated as a Indian income. Foreign income means the income earned and received outside India. If income is earned as well as received also outside India, then it is known as foreign income. So based on Indian income and foreign income, an individual has to pay the income tax. Now we'll see the little detailed format. So this is a table showing incidence of tax, incidence of tax liability or incidence of tax. So under that, first one is income received in India, whether earned in India or outside India. If income is received in India, if income is received in India, then all the people has to pay income tax, means ordinarily resident taxable in respect of Indian income. Means Indian income means what? It is received in India. Not ordinary resident also has to pay tax on the Indian income. Non-resident also has to pay tax on the Indian income. So it means all the ordinary resident, not ordinarily resident and non-resident has to pay income tax if the income is received in India. If the income is received in India, then he has to pay income tax. Whether it is earned in India or outside India, doesn't matter. If the income is earned, received here, then they both three people has to pay income tax. Next, second one is income deemed to be received in India, whether earned in India or outside, wherever may be the income is earned, but if it is taken as income is deemed to be received in India, it is going to receive in India, then it is taxable in the hands of three people: ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident, and non-resident. It means it is an Indian income. It is an Indian income. It is going to receive in India means it is an Indian income. It is taxable in the hands of three parties. Next, income. Third point: income from business or profession earned outside India. Income from a business or profession earned outside India, but the same is controlled from within India. Means the income is earned outside India. It is a income, foreign income, earned outside India, but the same is controlled from India, within the India. Means the business is set up in India. The business is, this business or profession is set up in India or controlled in India. Its management of affairs is in India. It means it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident. So here we can see ordinarily resident, if both on all the income he has to pay, Indian income as well as foreign income. Not ordinarily resident has to pay even if the income is earned and controlled from India. In case of non-resident, it is not taxable. But ordinarily resident and not ordinarily resident has to pay income tax if the income is earned outside India and the business is set up in India. Next, fourth one is income from a business or profession earned outside India. Here it is earned outside India, but the same is controlled outside India. Earned outside India, so this is a foreign income. Who has to pay income tax on the foreign income? Only the ordinarily resident has to pay the income on the foreign income. Not ordinarily resident, no need to pay, and the non-resident also no need to pay income tax on the foreign income. So this is the income, which one? Income from a business or a profession earned outside India, but the same is controlled from outside India. Means the business also set up outside India, income is earned outside India, then it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. It is not taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident. It is not taxable in the hands of non-resident. Next, fifth point, income from any other source earned and received outside India. It is earned as well as received outside India means it is a foreign income. It is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident, not taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident as well as non-resident. Next, sixth point is past untaxed foreign income brought into India. Means there were some foreign income. It is past years, not relating to a previous year, but it is a past year in foreign income. It is not taxed, but it is that income an individual has brought into India. Then that income is not taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident, and not ordinarily non-resident. Means it is not relating. This income is not relating to the previous year. Next, seventh point: gift received from a relative is not taxable. And if the gift you from received from relatives and from anyone on the occasion of marriage, if it is received on the occasion of marriage, then it is not taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident, and non-resident. If gift is received from others, other than relative, others means other than relatives, then the gift value is above 50, up to 50,000 is exempt. Okay, up to 50,000, if the gift is received from others, then no tax, it is not taxable. If gift is received from others above rupees 50,000, then if the gift is received in India, it is taxable in the hands of all the parties. It is taxable in the hands of three parties. Means ordinary resident, not ordinary resident, and non-resident. If that gift is received outside India, then it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. So the taxable amount is entire amount. Means if the gift value is 60,000 received, it is above the 50,000 limit, then the entire 60,000 rupees is taxable in the hands of these people. Next, ninth one, income earned received outside India but later remitted to India. Actually, the income is earned as well as received outside India, means it is a foreign income, but later they remitted to India, means they have brought that income to India, means it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. It is not taxable in the hands of other people, means it is a foreign income. Foreign income is taxable in the hands of only in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, there are some points to be noted. First point is gift received from a non-relative, means other than that already explained, gift received from a non-relative is up to 50,000. If gift is received from a relative, then it is not taxable, it is exempt. And if the gift is received from any other person also, if it is on the occasion of marriage, it is not taxable. If that gift is received from on the occasion of marriage, anniversary, birth, on birthday celebration, then it is taxable. Okay, only if it is marriage, on the occasion of marriage, it is not taxable. Here, if the gift is received from others or relatives, however, it is exempt. If the gift is received from any other on the occasion of marriage, is not taxable. If that gift is received for other function, maybe birthday function or maybe a marriage anniversary function, like, then it is completely entirely taxable. Only for the occasion of marriage is non-taxable. So gift received from a non-relative means other person, it is tax exempt 50,000. Gift received from non-relative up to 50,000 is exempt, means up to 50,000 is exempt. From beyond that, fully taxable, full amount is taxable. Next, second one is dividend received from Indian company. Dividend received from Indian company is totally exempt. If dividend received from foreign company, then we have to pay income tax. Dividend received from an Indian company is totally exempt. So on the Indian income, all the people has to next. Third note is composite income, like income from tea business, coffee business, and centrifuge, latex, senex, rubber business are to be considered proportionately. We have to take proportionately. Next, fourth one is income from agriculture, that is a land situated in India. Income from agriculture from a land situated in India is exempt from tax. If the land is situated outside India, then it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Okay, foreign income outside India means foreign income is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. If income of from agriculture, from a land situated in India, then it is exempt from tax. Next, fifth one, income from the sale of nursery plants sampling is an agriculture income and hence exempt from tax. So these are nursery plants and sampling is an agricultural income, hence it is exempt. Income from sale of nursery plants sampling is an agricultural income, hence it is exempt from tax. Agricultural income from a land situated in India, it is exempt from a tax. Here we have still more items to be considered, whether it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident, and non-resident. If salary is received in India or services rendered outside India, so salary received in India, so taxable in the hands of all the parties. Salary received outside India but services rendered India, if the salary received or accrued here. income received as well as accrued in India is treated as Indian income. So here salary received outside India but services rendered in India, so it is taxable in the hands of all the parties. It is treated as a salary accrued in India, so it is taxable. Pension received outside India for the service rendered in India, so service is rendered in India, so we have to tax. Tax is payable by three parties. Next, pension received in India, service rendered outside India. Pension is received in India, so taxable. Pension received outside India for the service rendered outside India. Pension received outside India and service also rendered out. Foreign income. Foreign income is taxable in the hands of ordinary resident. Salary received from outside India for the service rendered outside India. So this is also foreign income from Indian company or foreign company. It is taxable outside India. Income from agricultural land in India is exempt. Income from agricultural land situated in India is exempt. If it is situated outside India, then we have to taxable in the hands of ordinary residents since it is a foreign income. Profit from a purchase and sale of standing crop in India means profit. Here, profit is taxable. Profit from a purchase and sale of standing crop in India is taxable in the hands of it is. In India, so taxable in the hands of all the parties. Next, profit from purchase and sale of standing crop outside India, foreign income taxable in the hands of ordinary resident. Business income outside India and business is controlled from India, so business income, it is a foreign income, taxable in the hands of ordinary resident. And if the income is controlled from India, then it is taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident. Means if the business is set up in India, so it is taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident also. Next, business income or business income for the business in India. So business is in India, then directly we can pay, all the three has to pay tax. If it is controlled from outside, wherever, if the business in India, accrued in India, then it is taxable. Professional income, professions in India, it is taxable in the hands of all the people. Set up outside India doesn't matter, it is a profession in India means it is accrued in India, so it is taxable. Professional income outside India means foreign income. So this income set up in India means it is taxable till second column, not in the last column. Set up or controlled in India means we have to take for till second column. Next, foreign income or professional income accrued and received outside India. So this is accrued as well as received outside India. So taxable in the hands of ordinary resident. Rental income received in India, accrued India or outside. If it is received in India, then taxable in the hands of other three. Rental income from a property situated outside India but received in India. So received in India means we have to pay tax. All the three has to pay tax. Rental income from a property in India. Property is in India means the income is earned in India, accrued India. Property in India means income is accrued in India but received outside India, then it is taxable with all the three means it is in India. Income is accrued, earned in India means the property is situated in India. Rental income from a property outside India but received outside India, so it is entirely outside. Foreign income, it is taxable in the hands of only in the ordinary resident. Next, profit on the sale of property situated in India. Property situated in India, then it is taxable in the hands of all the three. Received in India or outside, doesn't matter. If it is earned in India, then it is taxable by all the three. Next one is profit from a sale of property situated outside India. Property situated outside India, but the profit is received in India. Received in India means it is taxable in the hands of all the three. Received outside India means it is becomes foreign income, so it is taxable in the hands of ordinary resident. Next, interest on post office saving bank account received in India, it is taxable in the hands of all the three. And if it is outside India, it is taxable in the hands of ordinary resident. So here interest on post office saving bank account is exempt up to ₹3,500. So up to ₹3,500 is exempt. So if it is 10,000, interest is 10,000, then 3500 means 6500 will be taxable. Got it? Up to 3500 is exempt, so balance is taxable. Not the entire 10,000 is taxable, balance is taxable. Interest on bank deposits accrued and received in India, accrued also in India, so it is taxable in the hands of all the three. Accrued and received outside India means it is a foreign income, taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, interest on foreign branch of an Indian bank received in India, so it is received in India, foreign branch of an Indian bank received in India, then it is taxable in the hands of all the three. If it is received outside India, then it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. So it is in foreign branch of Indian bank. Next one is Indian branch. Here, in case of Indian branch of a foreign bank, if it is received in India, means it is received in India, so it is taxable in the hands of all the three. So it is received outside in India, interest is received outside India, but it is a Indian branch, so hence it is accrued in India, so it is taxable in the hands of all the three. Next, interest on foreign branch accrued or received outside India, entirely it is outside India, so it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Dividend from an Indian company, whether it is received in India or outside India, it is exempt. Dividend from an Indian company is exempt, means individual no need to pay the income tax on the dividend received from the Indian company. The company will be paying the income tax for the dividend. So here individual, the person one who receives the dividend, no need to pay the tax to the government for the dividend received. So dividend received from Indian company is exempt if it is received in India or outside. Dividend received from foreign company is taxable. If it is received in India, then it is taxable for all the three. If it is received outside India, then it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. Interest on Indian government, central or state government security, so it is received in India. Accrued in India means it is taxable in the hands of all the three. Interest is taxable, only dividend is exempt. Okay, interest from foreign government, foreign companies government, so if it is received in India, then it is taxable to all the three. If it is received outside India means there is no Indian connection, so it is a foreign income, taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, 30th one, interest or dividend from a cooperative society in India means it is accrued in India, received in India, so it is taxable in the hands of all the three. Outside India means it is a foreign income, so it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Interest on security from an Indian company, interest is from Indian company is taxable, dividend from Indian company is not taxable. Okay, dividend from Indian company is exempt. Interest from Indian company, interest on securities from an Indian company, if it is received in India, then it is taxable in the hands of all the three. It is received in India, so we have to pay, all the three has to pay income tax. Received outside India means, India means here all the three has to pay tax. Reason is it is from an Indian company, so it is accrued in India, so it is taxable by all the three. Interest on security from a foreign company, here interest on security from a foreign company, received in India, means all the three has to pay tax. Received outside India means it is foreign company and received also outside India, so it is a foreign income, so it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, a gift from a friend, if it is received outside India. See here, gift from a friend. Gift already explained. Gift from a friend. If it is from friend means others. If it is received outside India, taxable. Received in India, taxable in the hands only in for these three. Outside India means only your ordinarily resident has to pay tax. Gift from others is taxable. That is condition also there. Up to 50,000 is exempt. Beyond that is not taxable. Exempt. If the gift is aggregate not exceeding 50,000 means up to 50,000 is not taxable. Beyond that, then it is taxable from a friend or other. gift from relative, specified relative means there is a condition for relative. Gift from relative is if it is received in India or outside in India, it is entirely exempt, but there is a condition, who are relatives here. So relative means it is a relative includes spouse means wife, brother, sister, maybe brother and sister of that person, individual, or a brother of sister of spouse, brother of sister of parents of that individual. Parents also, if the gift is received from parent, then it is a relative. Brother or sister of a parent, like uncle, auntie, any lineal ascendant or descendant of individual or spouse is treated as a relative. So gift from a relative is if it is received in India or outside India, it is exempt. So if the gift are in kind, if the gifts are in kind, it is not in cash, if the gifts are in kind, then it is they are not taxed in the hands of SSC. If the gifts are in kind, then it is not taxed. But the condition again, if it is jewelry, immovable property, shares and security, then it is taxable. Excluding jewelry means these are taxable. Gift in kind is not taxable. These are excluded means it is taxable. If the aggregate gift exceeds 50,000, entire amount is taxable. That is already given. Interest on post office saving bank account in India is exempt up to ₹3,500. This is exempt up to ₹3,500 under section 10(15), and excess amount is deductible under section 80TTA up to ₹10,000 along with the interest on bank saving bank account. Means above, if for example, if interest on POSB account is 10,000, in that 3,500 is exempt. Balance 6,500 is taxable. Taxable. So we have to take as taxable. Again, that taxed amount, how much is 6,500, can be deductible under section 80TTA. So if he receives interest on the saving bank, post office saving bank account, and it is taxable beyond 3,500, and the balance whatever he paid tax on this will be deductible under section 80TTA. There is a deduction under section 80, he can reduce that income. So that also up to 10,000 he has can record and deduct along with the interest on bank saving bank account, along with the post office saving bank account as well as bank saving bank account.